Good afternoon, Mr. Wu. Welcome back. Hey guys, how you going? It's Gil here from Tactical Edge Hobbies. All right, so the most highly anticipated blaster of 2020, without no lie, this has surpassed the P1, or the Kublai P1, I should say. This is definitely something that you guys have to get excited for, and I'm talking about the 2011 TTI STI High Kappa Baba Yaga. Let's have a look. There it is, guys, the TTI STI 2011, the Baba Yaga. Now, I've got a display model right in front of me. Now, I'm gonna be using this. Now, there is quite a lot of similarities with obviously the XTP and whatnot, but then there's differences as well. So I'm gonna talk about the magazine, how to fill the actual canister into the magazine. But let's talk about some of the features of this particular blaster. As you can see, it clearly has all the TTI markings and insignias that is needed to know that it's definitely a licensed blaster. In particular, you can see the 2011 and the STI markings right there. And of course, on the magazine, it does come with the TTI insignia as well. So this is definitely a licensed blaster, guys. So I can't say enough about this. It's just perfection. When you hold it, it feels balanced. When you shoot it, it's got a nice recoil as well. The other cool thing, like any other 2011 or 1911s, you've got quite a few safety options, okay? So you can't really just pull the trigger like so. The actual hammer lock is right there, located like any other 1911, so you have to actually hold the pistol and then the hammer will be released. And that's only when you're holding the handle properly. Another cool feature is the slide lock as well. So if you've got that slide lock up, it won't shoot back. Now, the only con I have about this blaster, and this is the smallest con, is that sometimes if you're wearing gloves or anything like that, you could accidentally pull the slide lock up when you're trying to shoot, and it will just lock up, okay, in the middle of a battle. So just always be mindful of where your thumb positioning is, and you should be all right, okay? But that is literally it. So why don't we talk about the multi-tool and the magazine right now? All right, so with the magazine, to undo the cap, grab your multi-tool, all right, with the long end, see how there's that little buttstop there? You're just gonna push that upwards. And sometimes, the only thing is that it is a little bit fidgety. Once that pushes up, that pops out, okay? Now, you're gonna go onto your Allen key lookalike, and you're just gonna pop it in there and unscrew, guys, okay? So I'll do that now, and we'll just come back once I've got that cap unscrewed. Okay, so once you've unscrewed, it's not gonna come all the way out. All you gotta do is just tip it out, and it comes out. Now, I've already got a canister in here. Now, the way this works is that the XTP and the Sharks normally go like so, right, neck up. Well, this one, it's actually neck down, okay? And then you put the cap in there. Now, be mindful though, when you put that cap in there, make sure you're not gonna cross thread or anything like that. It can get a little bit jerky. My advice is to have the multi-tool like so, and just tip it upwards so that it can catch. Once it catches, tip it down. Now, once it tightens, you will feel it tighten when it starts getting closer to the CO2 bulb, okay, like so. Then what you're gonna do is you're gonna quickly just crank it. So you're trying to eliminate as much gas not coming out because you're obviously piercing the canister, and that's it. Then you just slide this like so and pop that. Now, another thing I wanna give you just a helpful tip. If you're like me, who sometimes gets things wrong, and you decide to pop it in the wrong way, okay, the actual cap itself won't allow it to retract back most of the times. The reason why is because the actual spring for the gels to retract has a stopper right there. All you need is something to pop down the spring. So I'll show you what I mean. I'll just grab this item here. Okay, so normally, by now, see, it's kind of locked in now. I can't take it out. So what I'm gonna do with the long end is I'm gonna line it up where that spring is, and I'm just gonna push it down, and that will then slide out, okay? Just so you know, okay? That way you're not freaking out thinking, oh my God, I've just ruined my blast, and all you gotta do is just pop that back up and off you go. So, push that down, locks in, and you're ready to rock and roll. And just for you newbies, just to fill up the gels, pull that all the way down. As you can see, there is an enlarged section right so, that's where the gels, you'll pour the gels to go in, okay, with your speed loader. Okay, so that's really the magazine in a nutshell. Now, another hint that I want to, or not hint, but advice that I would give you is that don't leave the CO2 cartridge in the magazine, okay? Anytime you're done playing, it's always best to get into the habit of dispersing the CO2 completely, all right? Do not leave it in the magazines, because what's gonna happen is that built-up pressure is gonna blow the seals off your magazine, and that goes with all the other CO2 pistols as well. But enough teasing, because you don't wanna hear me talk, you wanna see this bad boy shoot, so let's go do that chrono. All right, guys, so here is the chrono test for the Baba Yaga 2011 TTI STI High Capper. Check this out. And we're out. So there you have it. That's how amazing this blaster is. It was averaging at 280 plus with ease, okay? And there it is, okay? The TTI STI 2011 Baba Yaga. You guys gotta come down and try this out for yourself. This blaster is going to change your life. It is so good. So there you have it, guys. This blaster is gonna turn any average Joe into Mr. Wick, definitely, okay? This blaster is definitely something that will give you the edge in the battlefield. I just can't speak highly enough about it. So please come on down to Tactical Edge Hobbies, give it a try. Now, for those of you who are new to the channel, what are you doing? Please subscribe, write a comment down below, and remember to click that notification bell so you're always up to date with Tac Edge related content. And we also do exclusive content throughout all our social media platforms. So that's TikTok, Instagram, and of course, YouTube and Facebook. Okay, anyway, as I always say, guys, stay fresh, stay blasting. Until then, I will talk to you guys later. Far.